Welcome back, all you crazy cool people. We are trying out a game called Kingdoms, and this has been around for a little bit. They had a little bit of problems getting itself up and going during the last update to this update. I've been watching it closely, and now I'm kind of willing to give it a shot and bring it to you guys to look at, because it seems pretty interesting now. I'm kind of liking what I'm seeing. It's still not perfect. It's still an early access game. And what is Kingdoms? It is a procedurally medieval RPG, randomly generated open world game. Which is a survival game too. The main features of Kingdoms is special smart AI systems with complete controls of NPC behaviors. All players can fully interact with the massive world and become any person you want to be. So that is pretty cool. They've added a whole bunch of cool things, including having troops and all that. We're going to look at that as we go through. Again, their patch notes around bomb is massive. Since we never played this, there's really no need to go through patch notes, since you know what? There's a lot to go through. So a game world, let's see us. Game edge. Edged. It, learn to spell. There we go. Yeah. Really cheesy, but yeah. All right, let's do it. All right, NPC amounts, 1,000. All right, day duration, 30. I don't know if that's good to leave it like that. We should leave it the basics. We'll leave it here. NPC spawn, pause, 3 seconds. That seems like a lot of people, 1,000. How big is this map? That's the curiosity. All right, let's see what this is. You can choose between male and female. Yes, we can. All right, age, we can bring it up to as old as you want to as young. And you can change the faces and stuff. Temple width, ears, and all that. We're not going to worry too much about these things at the current time. But if you guys want to see us, you can do depth of nose and stuff. Oh, I like that guy. That's cool. All right, let's go back to this. How do we do this now? We go next. All right, so now we have a whole bunch of different player parameters. These are skills you have, so we're going to go through them all here. We have Digger, which is this one here, which you can dig earth using shovel, which is really nice. Gardener, so this is wild plants. You'll be able to collect wild plants throughout the thing, and also you'll become herbalist afterwards. These things we can learn off other AI players as we go progress through the game. So the key really is to find out what we want to do to build ourselves. Chopper are strong enough to chop down trees, pretty evident. And after that, they can get benchmen, which is, can make different things. And then the carpenter, you can make different things, wood things. All right, cool. Pretty specific. Scholar itself, experience points. Again, I guess they're not marking down what it is. Okay, experience points needed is 10. So plus 25 experience points every time. Okay, so you keep on moving up a little faster. You can build houses using different materials. Worker, that we should learn. Okay, we're going to learn that. And so we have 15 experience points left. Trader, you can build small shops. Price are 5% better. Huh. Interesting. All right, we'll look at that afterwards. Swordsman, of course, you can be able to attack and stronger in combat energy, of course. Traveler, you can travel a little faster. My God, butcher. Plus 1 meat on all animals. Pioneer, what is this? Stamina refills faster. This is pretty interesting. Blacksmith parameters, now this is perks, you know, it's iron. Okay, so that's it. We can work in iron. Novice archer. And I think that's it. I think that's all we have here. Traveler, this. So we're going to do archer. Sorry, we're going to do, sorry, worker. Garden seems to be very important. Chopper, I think, would be another one that would be very important, right? I have to say so. Gardener would be quite important, too, if you think about it. But can we move up now to the next one? We could do Taskmaster, okay. I like the trader part that we can open up our own store, but I don't know how long it would take for us to do that. I like the traveling part a lot faster. Blacksmith, apprentice, butcher. I'm going to do gardener. We're going to need that. And digger, collect items. Well, plants, dig earth with shovel. Well, that's pretty explanatory. Traveler, butcher, blacksmith, apprentice, novice archer. God, what's the next one we should do here? Herbalist, benchman. Benchman does what again? You can wood and make different things. That sounds pretty important. I think we're going to go with the benchman too. And we'll worry about making money afterwards. We're just going to give it a shot anyway. So let's... Oh, you don't have an experience points. It's 10 for this one. Okay. Then we can't do a secondary one. So we won't do scholar. We'll do a trader. How about that? There we go. All right. So we just spy on didn't. It sees now it says tab for diary. All right. Let's see this here. So hit points, 100. Vigor. And I guess hunger is... This bar goes up as you get more hungry. All right. So that's good. We have to watch out for that. Right now, we're okay. We have what on us? A rich man's hat. Really? All right, should we put that on? I guess we have to put on clothes. Some pants. Which way gives us what? Defenses plus 3. That's pretty good. We have a sword in case we need it. That's nice. I guess we should hold on to that. Do we have a hot bar or something? That'd be pretty interesting. We have 200 gold. That's pretty interesting. I didn't know we could start off with gold either. What do we get? We have a steel axe. Wow, that looks like a hell of an axe. Do I have to put in these things? So this should have been weaponry. This is what? Secondary. No. I guess a torch or something? What is this? We start with some wood. Pickaxe? Nope. Okay, I guess we're going to do torch. Yeah. All right, so it gives us a torch and our axe. Ooh, I guess we don't do that. We do tab again. All right, so let's see the features here. This is the other one here, active quest, game edge tutorial, which is what we want. So Aurel, being part of kingdoms, please read the following tutorial and control building systems and combat. Also remember, this is a very early alpha game and as many bugs might be. Okay, so this is just regular stuff. We want to go back to the Steam page and check it out. So it says, enjoy. Thank you. So now we also see the other levels we have here. So right now we can actually collect wild plants, which is nice. Chopper, worker, and trader. And settlements. So building, we can do is these kind of buildings we can build. So we need wood for each one of these buildings. Now settlement itself, when you put it down, you need to be a scholar, which we need to learn. So we can actually make our own settlement. We can live in another place and build buildings, but we need to learn to be a scholar. I think I should have chosen that. But this is actually an icon you put down. So you put down, oops, damn, I have to stop doing that. You put the icon down here. Is the sound not on? Yeah, they're on. All right, cool. I turn off the music, unfortunately, for copyright issues, so no choice. And plus, it's just music. All right, so we can build these things here. Perks is Scholar and Taskmaster. Common house. Ouch. All right. If we build other houses, yes, we can. So we can build small wood houses, which takes 5 times wood, 7 times wood for a larger wooden house and 2-level wooden house. So this gives you a whole bunch of things. We can cook food. We can do a whole bunch of cool things. We can make a garden, and we also make a farmhouse. This is probably key for us to do. We can make our installment afterwards. So craft with a work desk. What is this? You were crafting different items with a working desk. Work desk. All right, so we can actually make stuff here. Wood planks. And crafting, right? I guess we just do craft. So we make one craft. So it speeds up times 8. All right, so since crafting, I'm actually stuck in this. My mouse disappeared when I clicked that. That may be something I have to work on. All right, cool. So this gives us what, some planks. So it turns into planks. I'm not sure we can do that, but that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. All right, let's move out of that. And let's just see one more thing here to make sure we've gone through this. And troops. So yeah, that's it. You can command troops to attack certain animals and stuff. We got to be careful. Unfortunately, there is bears in this. Yes. Yes, there is. All right. Now, don't forget, this is early access. And there's our stamina bar on the bottom. So we have to be careful. Now, I have this. What's the settings on this? It should be on optimal, right? They don't give us any video. Sun rays. Dynamic depth of field. Bloom. I don't know. Contrast, brightness. I guess there's really not that much, is there? Yeah, I don't know which ones are which, so we're just going to go back and enjoy the game. The game so far looks pretty nice. It looks interesting. We had to be careful, like I said, for animals and stuff. There will be settlements throughout these things. And if we press an M, I think we have a map. You'll see those little question marks. So you have dungeons in here, which we're not prepared to go, but we have to look for settlements. So we probably should point towards us. We have a settlement right behind us. Right past that mountain. We should probably go and check that out. Let's take away the map there because it's just going to drive me nuts. But yeah, the game looks pretty interesting. I mean, it looks like it needs some work. I don't know if the depth of field issue. I don't know if that would really help or not. Let's check that out and see if that's the problem. Let's apply these. Ooh, God, Bloom is too bloomy. Is it? I don't know. Let's see. Let's see what that looks like. Return, okay. All right, that didn't fix very much, but it's okay. I don't know the dynamic is. I don't see the difference. There is some work to be done, but this game sounds interesting so far. I think I see a bush or something we could pick up right there. Now these things, there is things all over the world we build, pick up. Our stamina does come back as we're running, as we're walking, sorry, so that's good. Now I think we got to be herbalist to pick up some of the plants. I don't think we have those yet. Like these ones, we can't pick that up. We pick you up. we cannot. All right, there's a little fox. I guess we could butcher him if we had the skills. We're not. Oh, gather. What do we have here? Wild berries. All right, that's cool. All right, for an early access game, it's not so bad. Those trees are making noise. Holy crap, that scared the crap out of me. Sorry, I was just looking at the map there for a second. Look back up, game edge. I should. Can we pick these up? No. See enough of those in. I thought I heard something. We do have to be careful. I should probably put our sword in place. Oh, I gotta stop that escape. I'll have to see if they have any keen binding. I don't think they do. Be able to pick up flowers and stuff. I'm not sure if these flowers will be anything, but there's something over this hill. I'm curious to see. Nighttime has fallen across the land. What did I do for putting a torch? Oh, I press one. Okay. Can I do torch and sword? Oh, we can. All right, that's cool. Is this what we were supposed to look for? Now, these are probably dungeons. We don't want to go into dungeons just yet. We're going to want to avoid those for the startup, but for the game's sake, we're just going to walk in really quick for us to see what it looks like. Anyway, it's just a trial run to see what we can do. I mean, from what I know and I've heard, it's actually playable to actually make a full, little trial kind of let's play. But this block is in the way. What do we do here? Oh, press E. You have nothing in your hands. Okay, gotcha. If you have nothing in your hands, you can open the door. All right. The sounds are really bad. And I wonder if the music really does affect it. I'm going to test this out. If I have to block or come back in a second because of music, I might have to pause it. We have to test this out to see. Supply. If music is on a sound. Turn. I don't know if the sound's there. I guess herbalist, you can actually. All right, it's hitting it. There's some gems and stuff in here. Now, I'm not sure what you're going to find in these caves. Yeah, I'm going to have to be careful because of the copyright. Fortunately, we're going to have to go without it because if you get hit, especially these early access games, you get hit with a copyright strike on YouTube and it's like, it's finished. Yeah, so these would be gems you can pick up as you learn. I don't want to get lost in this freaking cave, but this is mammoth. Is there any treasure in this place? I don't know if we find treasure or not. I really don't. I don't know where the hell I am right now. This place looks mammoth. It looks like somewhere I can get lost very, very, very easily. I don't want to get lost right now. Holy crap. I think that's the exit right there. Yeah, it's the exit. Whew. I got worried that we're going to have to start this over again and go, hey, by the way, there's a brand new Let's Play again. Because Game Ed's got lost. Wow, some of these things are really cool, though. They're cool looking. Yeah, dynamic depth of view. I think it's this thing here. You walk up something, look. Let's see if that's what it is. I need to know for the game itself, dynamic depth. Yeah, that's what it is. Okay, I don't like that. It's like a blur. All right, well, we'll come back and look at this stuff later on when we actually have a reason. You get to the center of the towns and form what take this off. Or have one hand at least. No, nighttime has definitely come in. So where's the other? There's another one to the right. Now, usually near towns, near these kind of things, are supposed to be, from what I heard, supposed to be towns nearby. So that's something to look for. Now, we have to be careful for bears and other things. We are going to try and build at least something. I'm hoping to find a town so I can build near it. We could chop down some wood. But the game does have its own. I mean, I just want to look at the way this is running. The stamina thing goes on a little too fast for me, but again, I think all games, the stamina goes down. I guess if I had a Traveler perk, it would be a lot easier. All right, there's trees just being near them. So the sound as you approach the trees themselves is where it comes out. All right. So the axe we got because we are, because we have actually the skill, will actually give you a better axe than you would with a regular one. That's the slowest slice ever. Okay, that's something they'll have to work on. But again, we're looking for game, the actual game itself, and if it's playable and how it's going to run. All right, let's look at the map. Where are we at? All right, we're right there. We're almost there, so we'll see. If this is another cavern or whatever, we're just going to go near the forest and get some trees. And that's all we'll have to do. So far, a pretty interesting little game. Has possibilities, that's for sure. Now, you can find this on IndieDB. I found this on IndieDB, which is a indie game site, which a lot of indie guys will put up and post there. And it's actually on Steam now, and I think I got it on special. Discover, I think it's on special now, too. So, Drillium is discovered. What is that? It's a different town. Is there a town nearby here? There's some guy right here. All right, maybe we should put away our sword. Let's put the sword away because we're going to approach somebody. Now, you can get experience points from what I know for helping building. Looks like it's a woman. All right. Can we talk to her? Not enough wood for inventory. Oh, no, I just want to talk to her. Can we go in there and talk to this girl? Or she's just going to continue building without us? She'll pop back out. We can help her out getting some wood. How about that? Let's go and do that. Now, it's strange how it's on a left side hand, and when you look at here, it's on a right. That's awfully weird. Kind of throws you off. All right, so you have to take away that. Let's see how long it takes us to chop down a tree. I can actually hold down, can I? I can. All right, the animation is not phenomenal, that's for sure. Two wood added. Oh, she didn't want this tree. How much wood does she need still? How much wood do you need, honey? Please tell me. 5. So I press E. E. So I'm helping her out now. She's need 3 more. And I got experience points for that. All right. Wood added. Now can I... Oh, can I continue doing this? That would be cool if it was actually like that. No. Nope. All right. This tree isn't here, right? It's not here, but it is here. All right, how about the stump? Can we get some more from the stump? Can we get rid of the stumps? I don't know if this tree is supposed to disappear or not. Again, early access, and they're redoing the game the way it works. All right, it's just disappeared. So 2 wood added. How much more can we get from the stump? 2 more wood added. Oh, 10 experience points. We're getting some serious amount from the stump. Good thing is a torch actually could not be used while you're doing this. And it's not so bad. At least with the bloom, it turns out pretty good. I'm sure lighten it up. All right, cool. 2 more. Wow. I'm kind of impressed. Our stamina is dropping pretty quick. We'll probably have enough for a couple more. Wow, this stump is like, has more wood than the actual tree itself. Or is that what it's considered still? It's considered the full tree, and they're probably working on that part of it. Probably just built to get a lot more logs, so they're giving you the amount through the stump at the current time. That's probably what it is. Well, she's still going at it. Once we build her house, we should be able to talk to her. Yeah, let's go and talk to her. We'll take care of that stump afterwards. All right, let's do E. There you go. We built your house for you. Huh? Are we not nice or what? We are the nicest guys ever. All right, where's your entrance? Oh, there you go. All right, so this is like a simple little house. We just walk in. We can. And it looks like you're kind of, you don't realize it's done. Why are you bothering me, stranger? All right, well, nice settlement you have here. Can you tell me about it? There we go. Was it your Drillium village? There are 1 sellers here, or do we need to be more specific information? All right, well, don't be. Who should I tell about? All right, what should we do? Okay, who's your leader? It's somewhere. He must be here somewhere, quite easy to find in a village, right? So there's this village is brand new. and they spawned in. Fortunately, there's no merchants at this current time. All right. And how about here? Intellectual. All right. What can she teach me? If I get experience points, which I have, oh, I got some somewhere. These are the ones here that we know. Right here, if I'm mistaken. Mine work, is it? No. These are the ones she can teach us, right? And this one she can't. She doesn't know it. All right. So the green ones are the ones we know because a harp, that's it. So we'd have to learn digger first. Not enough experience points. I thought we had some for helping out. Go and check that out. She's either that or she's being really mean. All right, how do we get out of this thing now? Are we jammed in? Back to dialogue. Okay, I have to click that. All right, cool. I don't have an experience points. I don't get that. All right, back to dialogue. That has to change. That menu doesn't look nice at all. All right, let's go back out of here. How do we get out of here? Can you tell me more, something interesting? Of course, what exactly do you need? I know. There's something strange with the ruins. You may want to try to stay away from it. Okay, so she's showing me the right direction for that. And I just marked it on my map. All right, and how do we get out of this? All right, we just press escape. Cool. So she has a work desk here. It seems like we can use it. Wheat seeds and stuff. We can actually do those kind of things. I don't think we have the perimeters to do that yet. We have to learn how to do that. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Work desk. Where's the exit? All right, that little exit button. Horrible, horrible exit button, but it's okay. Early access. Be patient. Roasted meat. So this is stuff we can actually cook up if we actually had it. Meat. So that's a cooking table. And I think we can use our bed if we want to. Can we wait till sunrise? Sunrise, sunset, I guess. All right, let's sleep. Speed. Plus one. And it looks like it's daylight. Yes. Very nice. Very nice. Get that torch out of her face. Oh, yeah, the sunrise is coming. Boy, that's bloomed out, eh? Wow. All right. That's really bright. Really bright. Okay, so we helped her out. She got her things done. She won't teach us anything. I don't know why. So let's go and see what we have in points and perks. Level one, experience. Okay, so that's it. The points only come up when we hit 500 experience. So that's why we had that problem. All right, cool. I got to stop pressing escape. Now we could build here if we want to. That bloom is really bright, man. That's like, my eyes are hurting. How much wood we have? What's our inventory look like? Right now we have one. We have quite a bit of wood actually. Can we build? That's what I want to do. Let's build something. Let's build inside her settlement. Oh, she's tired. Look at her. She's still going at it, but she's on the outside now. Hopefully that'll be something they'll fix as they go through, but we're going to build herself a farm. She needs a farm in this area. I think that's what she built, but I'm going to compete against her and build her farm here. I'm going to build it right here, smack in here. Farm name. Okay. Here we go. We'll do Chronic. Make him happy. Start using, guys, your names. I think that's it. Chronic. Chronic's farm. All right. There we go. Let's get some more wood. Now, this stump is crazy. Like I said, it's probably just because it's meant to be the entire tree. And it's not gone completely yet, so they've probably left it like this, and then they're working on it. At least a tree falls is pretty good. That's definitely a nice add-on to the game. I'm pretty sure the stump does disappear after a while. I think it's gone now. I think it takes a little while for it to disappear. Yeah, we can't hit it anymore. All right, take it easy. Put the sword away. All right, that's a little lag on his animation there. Okay, he's feeling better now. How much logs do I need now? I got to put the axe away when I'm doing this. Oh, wow. We built it. All right, so put that away. First form done. All right, let's go back to our main menu here. Let's take the torch out of the way. Actually, wait, I can only leave the torch. Can I put something else in my hand? It's just annoying that I can't. Can I put this there? No, it really, really doesn't have a choice. All right, so be it. All right, let's build the farm. Again, this probably needs a little bit of work. well, a little bit more and a little bit of work, but definitely need some work. Can I put it inside the house? No. So I guess you're limited of where you're going to place these things. I'll put the first one right in front of it. I'm sure you want to build a garden here. Yep. Okay, Mr. Scaffolding. How you doing? All right, we have two. We need 10 more wood. Let's go up here and check out to see. Same time, we probably see on the side here whether or not she made it. It's just pointing this way. There's some more ruins. But again, there'll be a board that goes up in the middle of town as she builds. And the board itself will actually tell us... there's a fox over there again. The board itself will tell us like different adventures we can take. That's as per the... I hear a freaking bear. There's a bear over there. Way over there. And we're not going that way because they will attack. And you know our experience with bears, right, lately? It's never good. There's not many trees. Why would she build so far away from freaking trees? Hey, fox? Tell me. Oh, you don't have to worry. I'm a slow swinger. I thought he was coming to kill me. It's like, great. Killed by fox. I'll be like, oh. Better than being killed by a honey badger, I guess, or something. All right, come on. So it's best to go out there and get some more wood. I'll probably do that off camera, most of it. Try and grab as much. But again, our inventory is pretty limited. We're tired now, so we've got to take a little rest. But that bear is on that side. My gosh, she should have said, by the way, there's a freaking bear on that side. Now, obviously, in the distance, it's not coming out rendering pretty nice. It's missing quite a bit of work on that. But the game overall... has possibilities, and this looks pretty cool for another indie developer that's, you know, working it out. Now this would be a difference between this and subsistence. If you think about it, this game has been around for, oh shit, I'm glitching. Yikes, a spindle tree, what I've always wanted. Oh shit, except when it lands on me. I didn't want it on me. I don't want to get caught in some kind of glitch or something I think kills us. Now, wait, now it's gone away from... No, it's not letting us do that. I was curious to see, maybe it's because it was attached to it. All right, so that tree's just going to roll around there and finally disappear, I guess, as I'm cutting down this part. Take some more of the actual... There we go, see? It's gone. So that's something they'll have to work on, too. Definitely. Now, this is open world. It's massive, supposedly, so... I'm just going to press a map and I can't even see it. All right. Can we zoom out? Should go back to map, brother. Thanks. Okay. I can roll out on a map. Let's see how big this baby is. Holy Jesus. It keeps on getting bigger. Wow. That is mammoth. Okay. Well, this is really a huge, huge undertaking from this developer with a massive map to start off with. That is a lot of work to be put into it. Let's just get a couple more pieces. So it's not bad. I think there's a possibility we can try and build up at least our own settlement, see what it looks like. You know, it doesn't have to be everyday kind of game, but definitely would like to see the progression of this one and keep track of it. If you guys like this, don't forget to mark it in the comment fields and hit the like button. If you want to see a little more of it, you make sure you do the same thing, please. I hit it up in, you know, comment fields and marker and think about, you know, you guys want to see a little more of this game. And you can pick it up yourself, too, for like, I think, $6 right now on Steam, which is ridiculous. $6 Canadian. It's probably $6.99, I think it is, Canadian. So $6 American. Depends where you are in the world. So anyways, you guys go and look on Steam. I'll put a link inside the actual description field so you can do that for sure. All right, we'll just get a couple more pieces and we're going to head out. It's the last shop. We're going to head out right there. But yeah, pretty cool. I mean, for a few bucks... this can be playable, and hopefully the developers that get enough money, they can do a little more with it, right? I'm just saying, yeah, it does help. Cash helps. Trust me, you guys know it. Cash helps. You know, we can't feed ourselves without it. Now, stump's still there. That's kind of strange. I don't know. Maybe I was just tired. I don't know. There we go. Garden. All right. Well, we have nothing, do we? Plant that. Oh, we have berries. Can we plant berries? Well, we have to actually plant seeds of berries. That would make sense, wouldn't it? wood. All right. Well, I don't think we have anything we picked up just yet. But that's pretty good. What's our level right now? Experiences 325 of 500. We did pretty good just by hitting and making this. That's pretty cool. What else can we build? What else can we build? A camp. All right, we can camp. A little campfire would be nice. I think we need a little campfire outside. Did I not hit it? I forgot to press build, right? Is it invisible? Or is it because of hillside? All right, we can place it and see. Hill is too steep. Yeah, but it's invisible, so how the hell am I supposed to know where the hell it is? Sure you want to build a campfire here? No, not really. I want to build it somewhere logical. How about here? Is it still on me? Because hell, we don't know. How about here? Too close to structure. Oh, I can see it all the way over there. Do you see it? Over there now. I don't know why it's so far away. If I take a tool out, it'll fix it. No. It's like hovering in the air now. I don't like that. That's where it's going to probably land. Maybe just a little bit of a glitch. I know you can probably put these down. Build. Oh, there we go. Now I can see it. Welcome to Early Access Gaming. My name is Game Edge, and we are going to try to build a fire. All right, let's just do that for now. Probably no rationale, really, to do it, except I want to see what it looks like. And it's still building, so the green one is what, the building part of it? Or experience points? I don't know what that is. Okay, let's put this away. We can interact with it. Okay, so we can do food and stuff in this one, too. All right, cool. That's pretty cool. What else? Settlements. I could build other houses and stuff. Wooden house. There's other stuff. A bakery. You might build yourself a bakery. Yeah, we're going to build ourselves a freaking bakery. We're going to take over this town. Oh, there we go. We finally got it. Oh God, I'm choking on something. I don't know what the hell. I think it's the allergies. Early on in this game, I was choking. And I think it's the allergies. It's too close to the farm. It'd be nice on a hillside, though. It's just that it won't let me, will it? It'd be cool if it was like that right there. How about right behind it? Wow. We're limited, I guess, the hill, the way it slants. There we go. Okay, can we rotate this somehow? How about the number keys? We can't rotate it, so we're going to rotate it by what? We can't rotate it. All right. Right now, at the current time, you can't rotate. That's fine. Try and find a better location. But I guess we're going to just do it. I guess we're not staying here forever. We're just here for testing and trial. So, sure. I want to build a bakery right here. I said yes, please. Is it no? No. Okay. They don't want us to build a bakery here. Sure. Does it take a while for it to do, or is this a problem? No, I think it's a problem. There must be something interfering with it. That's kind of strange. I'll have to mess around with that on the side. Again, we're just going to check out what else we can do here. Shops. Ooh, a tavern and shops. Small shop. Small wood tavern. Who doesn't need a tavern in their village, eh? Especially in these times. Let's do a little tavern. Let's get these people liquored. Nothing says like a nice home like a tavern in medieval times, right? No, for some reason, this shit ain't letting me do it. Anyways, I'll mess around with those kind of keys and stuff. I'll worry about that afterwards. I'm going to leave the episode here. If you guys want to see more of this, I'm sure it's just a little glitchy little thing that has to go on. I'll probably have to reset and restart. Not restart, but reset the actual game. But yeah, if you guys want to see a little more of this, it'd be great. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this. We're just gonna walk in and check out our little farmhouse, because I'm sure some of you want to see it before it goes bye-bye. Well, bye-bye. Before we do other things, I do want to find other villages, but I want to see how this one grows. And I do want to make our own, so that'd be pretty cool. It looks pretty cool. Make our little farmhouse. I think we did pretty good. Yeah. Let's go inside. This we're going to stay anyways. Oh, we have inventory. Storage. Okay, how do we do that? It costs us money? Oh, no. Okay, we can move money if we wanted to. I gotcha. Berries, torches, pickaxe, and berries, I guess we'll move over. So that's good. We have a little bit of storage crate. Whoa, a little bit of a lag on that one. And we got ourselves a work desk like we saw before and a cooking table. We have another storage crate. It's not a real storage crate. It's just a crate. And we can sleep here. So that's awesome. All right, we didn't do so bad. Nice little start. So thank you so much for being here. You guys are absolutely awesome. Again, if you want to see some more of this, please don't forget to comment fields and hit the like button. It's always appreciated. This is Edge for Game Edge. And I'll catch you guys on the flip side.